the books of the priest, of the cardinal. Action of responsible extended to death muscle, extended digitorum muscle. This muscle starts from the jaw's middle and from the radius intersect and attach to the distal phalanges, base of the distal phalanges. Action of this muscle, extension of the fingers. Here we see a different special muscle extended in the index, the digit minimum, this one. Independence. And these muscles from the superficial layer of the muscles of the thumb. Deep layer contain supinator muscle. This muscle starts from the ulnar bone and attached to the radius bone. Action of this muscle, pronation outside, supination. Next muscle, extends abductor pollicis longus. This muscle attaches to the base of the frost phalanges. Action, movement, abduction of the toe. Next muscle, extends the pollicis brevis. Attach here, near the abductor pollicis. Extension, the toe into the metacarpal collagen joint. Next, extends the pollicis longus muscle. Attach to the distal phalanges. Extension of the distal phalanges. And last muscle, extension in the indices. Attach to the distal phalanges and index. Between the extensor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis at this region, we can see anatomical snuff box. Only put here tobacco and skull. This one, anatomical snuff box. The muscles of the dorsal come by the retinaculum extensorum. This makes the retinaculum extensorum. Muscles of the hand. At the hand, at the dorsal side of the hand, we see only dorsal interosseous muscle between the metacarpal box. The action of this muscle opens the hand. At the dorsal side. Between the tendons of the extensor digitorum muscles, we can see intertendinous connections. Between tendons, we see connection. And what can we see? If we put hand, if we move this finger, for example, together move these fingers. Yeah. Because here, separated, let me say, some connections. Palmar surface of the hand, we can see tenor, here situated muscles of the thumb, hypotenor, here situated muscles of the digitum minimum, and middle group, here's muscles, intermediate group. Muscles of the tenor contain four muscles. Abductor pollicis brevis, adductor pollicis contain transverse and oblique heads. Next, opponents, pollicis, these movements, and flexor pollicis brevis. Digitum minimum contain abductor digitum minimum, adductor digitum minimum, flexor digitum minimum, and opponents digitum minimum. And here situated plantaris brevis muscle. These are muscles of the tenor and hypotenor. Intermediate contain the lumbricalis muscle. Lumbricalis muscle, four muscles, start from the bones of the distal row of carpal bones and attach to the radial and proximal phalanges. Action of the lumbricalis muscle, flexion fingers into the metacarpal phalangeal joint. Notice, when we want to make flexion between distal and intermediate phalanges, work the deep flexor digitorum muscle. If you want to make flexion in the proximal, between the proximal and intermediate phalanges, this work superficial flexibilator muscle. If we make flexion metacarpal phalanges work, the lumbricalis muscle. And if all this muscle, lumbricalis, flexor digitorum brevis, and flexor digitorum longus muscle, give flexion. Topography. Carpal canal at the plantar surface. Canal, genacrum flexorum plates, and at the split, the canal through which passes the flexor digitorum muscle for security here. Anatomical snaggles. Your homework to the next class will be muscles on the forearm dorsal side and forearm. Next class, Saturday, I explain last muscles of the pelvic girdle and muscles of the leg. And next Wednesday and Thursday, ready test my own. You understand?
Yes.